broadcast live.
Mark Cooper Records.
Alright, welcome back to Loot on Life episode 2. I told you this month I'd be hanging out with some of the coolest, the dopest, the sexiest, the baddest. Of course I'm talking about femcees, and I don't like calling them that. They're just MCs. Today I get to hang out with Fifi Cooper's son. The baddest, and she's in all red. I wanted to get this all red. What's happening with the all red? Is that the family? Is that the squad?
Yeah,
they
well,
pulled you out the fire, so this is your vibe.
Color of life, color of, you know, everything nice, everything fire.
Right.
Yeah, it's my favorite color now.
Of course,
color
it's
of the year. Okay. So yeah, I'm like a red girl. If you look for a red girl, you'll find Fifi Cooper.
That's right. How you doing, mama?
I'm
you
great,
good?
Mommy. I'm great.
Well, thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you for inviting me.
You know, I was asking you just now before we started the interview, how many of you, these interviews have you been doing over the last couple of weeks?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
How's that, how's being back in this space? Like, how's it treating you?
It's really great. I would say I'm in a good space.
Yeah.
Especially now that I get to, you know, do whatever that I want.
Mm.
It's really important for me to have my freedom. So now that I have that, life is all good, man. And I don't mind. Like, this is my life. This is what I chose to do. And yeah, whatever that comes with it, I'm ready.
What? Tell me about how hard the your life was as a signed artist to eventually, obviously, didn't see eye to eye with the label. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
How heavy was that on you emotionally, financially, spiritually, mentally,
yeah,
physically even?
Yeah.
Especially as a woman.
Yeah. It was really, really tough for me. Like, I went through an emotional roller coaster. Like, there was a point, even my mom got, like, went to hospital because give out to body high blood, they stress too much because they get to just see these things moody, and they don't really understand. Yeah. So for me, that was heartbreaking. You know, I only have one mom, and I would never, you know, want to be the reason why she ends up in hospital. Mm. And that was really, like, hard for me. But, you know, I just had to keep pushing and pray that, you know, it eventually, you know, ends. Because everything has an ending at the end of the day.
Yeah.
And, you know, as an artist, I know that there will be challenges. And I just always tell myself that there's a reason why God is choosing me to go through this.
Yeah.
And I just have to, you know, be strong for me and my family and my fans and my son.
Mm-hmm.
So I just had to keep pushing and keep praying and keep hoping that,
and keep crying.
And keep crying, you know? Even though I don't cry on stage, I still get to go home and cry.
Right.
I still have, you know, I can drive to Mufftown when I feel like this is too much and just be with family. And that will just, you know, make me feel better and just remind me, you know, why I'm here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's been the most important lesson you learned from being in such an uncomfortable and very public fight with the label?
Yo, it's just so weird that, you know, you never know what could happen tomorrow. So for me, my biggest lesson from everything that has happened is, you know, just always be yourself and, you know, never give up. There will be people who will try to challenge you. And I think a lot of record labels, they feel like because they've made you, they can break you easily.
Of course.
And, you know, for me, I've learned that if you love me enough as an artist, let me go. Love me enough to let me go and see me doing, you know, bigger things, you know. It was just so weird that, you know, they've just been fighting me. It's not only the court case, there's just like fights every single minute about like little things, stupid things. And now that I have a record label, I've learned how to treat my artists. When I sign my artists, now I would know how to treat them.
Yeah.
And I know that artists are babies, like, you know, guess by any, but I've learned also that a record label, you need to work with your people. It needs to be like family. It works better if it's family, not like we are just making money.
Yeah.
We understand that it's business, but I've learned that, you know what, we are all family. If we are under one record label, we are all, you know, a family.
Mm. And what about the relationships with your ex-record label mates? You know, they've been seeing some things on the socials, you know, a bit of tension and all of that, but how is it now with the boys? You know, because you were one of the boys, you were part of the squad. You guys at some point definitely got along, you were family.
Yeah.
Obviously with sort of breakups, there comes, you know, having to choose a side,
yeah,
and they come, them having to be loyal, excuse me, to the label. But how are you guys doing now?
It's so weird that I actually don't have a, you know, relationship with any of the boys anymore. I feel like most of them, they were told not to, you know, talk to me and stuff like that. Even
thing.
Like, you know, yeah, even with MT, like, it's very difficult for me, like, to even talk to him. Like, I always have to go through management. You know, I tried to have him on the album. It was so difficult. They didn't want him to come record. It was just like a whole mess. And, you know, I just have to deal with it. At the end of the day, I came to this world alone.
Yeah.
And I know what I bring to the table, so I'm not afraid to eat alone.
Right.
So, yeah, so I feel like I'm good, man. If they feel they're ready to come back to me and we're cool, I can deal with that.
That's right.
So for now, I'm just doing my thing, and I know that they can see the moves, and I know that deep down they are proud, and it's just a matter of, like, you know, a lot of people are watching us, so people obviously want to see. So everybody's just trying to, you know, lay back, like, yeah, you know, not even be around me, because when my name pops up, there's different dramas, there's court cases, there's what. So people don't want to be associated with that, and I'm cool with it, you know. It's all good, man.
Do you feel isolated? Do you feel like you're alone? Do you feel like you're just in this corner and you getting a lot of, like, people turning your back and not really supporting you the way you expected?
Yeah. I mean, it's part of the lesson. I'm also learning that, you know, actually people are like that, legit. And at the end of the day, this industry is still a business.
Yeah.
And it's very difficult for artists that are actually under record labels, because they are told what to do, even what to rap, and even who to talk to and not to talk to. So I kind of understand, but I don't feel, like, isolated. I still have a family, my day ones, the people that were there with me even before the record label are still with me. Mo Cooper is, like, legit my day ones from Muff Town. Those people, I know that not on any day nobody's going to pay them not to talk to me, or nobody's going to pay them not to even be with me. So I'm good. I'm happy. I'm with people that I trust 100%, so I'm legit cool.
And on a lighter note, let's take it back actually to Muff Town. You know,
yeah.
I want to find out how it all started. You know, how you got into hip hop, how you got involved.
Yeah.
I mean, I can tell you were definitely one of the boys. I can see all that.
Yeah.
But where did this journey begin? You know, and why did you choose rap? Because as a woman, as a female, and as a black woman,
That's
not the easiest thing to be a part of. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
From your family thinking,
what,
like, do you mean you want to be a rapper?
Doing,
what are you talking about?
Yeah.
Or, you know, just the support in general of women in this space, in this industry, how difficult it's been.
Yeah.
And it's still very difficult in 2018 for women to stand and find a place and be acknowledged and accepted without being turned into a piece of meat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I actually feel like it's so weird how I started, you know, rap. I was a singer my entire life, you know. Ever since I was a local, I was just singing, go choiring at school. And because I believe in versatility, I just saw a gap that we don't have a female rapper who's going to represent where we come from, which is Muff Town. So I felt like we need a Motswako female rapper. And I was playing at the time. I was not serious. I was just like, you know, everybody's just loving this Motswako movement, Mumafikeng. So let me just try something out of my comfort zone. And I wrote a rap song, and that's when my life changed, you know. WHB gave me the title Motswako's First Lady. You know, I started performing.
Imagine that. Like, of all the things you choose one of the most difficult, which is rapping.
Yeah.
And then you're rapping, like, as a Motswako rapper, which is not an easy thing to do. You could have just gone the English route.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then, oh, hey, I wrote my first rap song, and here's WHP.
Yeah, you understand? It was just so weird. But I felt like I understand the sound, the Motswako sound, because that's who I really am.
Yeah.
And it was just so easy for me, you know, because I'm a writer, I'm a creative, I'm an entertainer. So I know exactly, you know, how to speak to my fans, how to, you know, interact with my fans. So it was not that difficult. It was just so weird that, like, everybody just started, you know, I even got the nickname Cooper from high school because I was the shortest. So the Fifi came from my real name, Rifilo. So it was easy. When I looked for a stage name, I was like, Fifi Cooper, done.
Right, you know, it was
just so easy. Everything was just falling into place. And I feel like everything happens for a reason. This is what God chose for me.
Yep.
And there's absolutely nothing I can do, because trust me, I love doing this. And it's my my life. So it was just so crazy when I started performing, you know, with your Kespas, mm-hmm. you know, Morafe. For me, back in the days, that was a dream come true. And for them, making it out of Mouth Town was really, you know, it proved to me that, you know, I can also do this. I can also come out from Mafikeng, from a small kasi called Muntiwa, and still make it in the big city lights of Joburg. So it's just so weird how things happen. But I feel like God, you know, there's a purpose for me in this life, and I think this is what God chose for me.
I like that. That's definitely right. God chose us for you. You can see it. You can.
Yeah.
It's beautiful to witness. You know what I mean? And in back then, obviously that's a very male-dominated space. The names you're mentioning, you know, Kaspar, Morafe, WHP, those obviously Kulichana, and then you were the only female.
Yeah.
And how did that ever count against you at any point? Did anybody ever take advantage of the fact that you're female, or make you feel some type of way just because, you know, you got some boobs?
Yeah, definitely. I think that's the one, you know, biggest challenge that we have as women in this industry. The fact that it's so male dominated, some of the people that you have to work with obviously will expect like something back in order for them to like help you with it. It doesn't matter, it can be like a beat or a set at a big event or whatever. So that has always been my biggest challenge, and I feel like whenever that happens, like maybe for instance, if it's like a producer who wants to sleep with me, for me to get a beat, like it always takes me like 10 steps back.
Yeah.
Because now we're working on the song and it's dope. Now I want to release it, and now you're playing games. Now you're fooling around and it's not Ayoba. I feel like I said before, I know what I bring to the table, so I'm not afraid to leave to eat alone.
Yeah.
I always like, I know that that's the biggest challenge that we have as women. So I'm always ready. Like I put it out there. I tell you straight that legit, we are working on the song. If you need money, tell me now so I can pay you. If you are genuinely helping me out, let's do it and release the music.
Sure.
Rather than let's meet up, we are meeting up at a club now, it's fun, we want to go back to the studio after we get, after we record, now you come with funny stories. No, I don't play that game anymore. I've learned my lesson. I don't mix business with pleasure. I don't do that. I don't even want a boyfriend who's gonna come here because he wants to write on the name. Some people have, rap. You know, some people, you know, come into your life because they have different intentions.
Sure.
So it's very difficult for you to just open up to anybody or like just work with anybody. So for me now, I've learned that even with the people that comes into my life right now, I need to know where you stand, my brother, so we can legit work and, you know, put this work out there.
Sure. So you've literally had to toughen up.
Yeah.
Be aggressive.
Yeah.
Just to protect yourself.
True.
Mostly because you're a female.
Yeah.
Also, you're tiny.
Yeah.
Anything can happen.
Yeah.
Anything can, someone can literally pick you up, and that's it. Like,
but I'm so blessed. I feel like I'm, you know, the last born, and I'm the only girl in my family. I have two brothers.
Oh, dope.
So that's where.
Dope.
I grew around boys, even with the swag game. I would always like steal my brother's t-shirt because he had like the coolest t-shirt.
Yeah, the latest.
You know, so even with the swag, even with the way I am, like it all comes from how I grew up.
Right.
And how I was raised, where I come from, and that's just who I am.
Mm. And speaking of your image and your swag and how you obviously were influenced heavily by your brother.
Yeah.
You know, you're a woman, you're grown, you're 26 now?
27
now. And obviously in some spaces you want to be very feminine, you want to be very sexy.
True.
Have you ever felt that in this space and in this place that you work in terms of hip hop and being around so many men, you rather opted to not be the sexy version of yourself?
Yeah.
Just to keep everybody, you know, at a distance.
Yeah. Like I said, this is who I am, and I've heard people in my life like dissing me a lot because people will always have, you know, this image of a female rapper. Now because Nicki Minaj is naked, they expect every female rapper to be naked. And I've told myself that, you know what, at the end of the day, I need to keep going with what makes me happy, mm-hmm. because I can't please everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I've had people, like, obviously, you know, wanting to dress me because they complain about my style. I'm always wearing long pants. You don't understand. Maybe it's because of the confidence that I don't have. You know, you always have like, ish, but today, ish, my tats are not showing okay. Like, you always have that as a woman. But I feel like, with my swag, It's just who I am. Mm. And I want people to listen to the music first before they look at me physically.
True.
You know, I don't want people to just want to see me at shows.
Yeah.
But I want people to buy a copy of my album and listen to it because they're not expecting to see me to listen to me.
Sure.
Yeah.
Freedom.
Freedom.
Broadcast live.